Okay, so in Sprite Part 2, we have built all of our sprite animation. Now we just need to tweak it, resize it, and then create a bigger sequence or a combination sequence with all these different sequences together to create a more realistic animation. So before we do that, though, I have to point out that I just named this Knight, K-N-I-G-H-T, of the Living Dead. That's awesome. That was a great idea. So I think I should make this game. But anyway, let's go ahead and see what we're doing here. We have all of these guys stacked, and it's just utter chaos. And each one of them, when you double click, he is a movie clip, and he has his animation, and it's staggered. So we create a specific sequence of motion. And if we go back out to the main timeline, now we just need to sort of get them to the right size so we can do our final animation tweaks. So the way I usually do this is I take my first sprite, and it doesn't really matter which one you want to choose, and I'll resize him to the size that I want him to be in the animation. Now, you probably don't want him this big because, as you can see, I've got some pixelation happening here, but you can choose, you know, whatever size looks good to you. So that's about the size I want. Now, the thing is, you don't want to make all these other ones, you don't want to resize them based on, you know, the position of their feet, which I used to do before I got smarter with this animation, or maybe where the top of their head hits, because as you can see, they kind of all hit at a different point. So what I usually do is I go up to view and go to rulers and drag down a guide from the top ruler. And guides are kind of just these invisible things that help you line things up. So I have those two guides there, and that's going to allow me to ensure that this character maintains a size by making sure that his head is exactly the same height as the original character. So for each one of these, I'll go ahead and unlock them, and I'll grab one at a time and change the width and move it down and sort of try to make sure. See how this one looks a little bit smaller? And by the way, when you're doing this, make sure that you have this link selected so that it's moving both the width and the height and you're not getting squashed weirdness happening. So I'm going to use the arrow keys just to nudge it. All right, so there's the knight run. The knight walk is done. Let's go ahead and try. I don't even know which one this is. All right, so this must be the knight dead. He's about to die. So we'll make him a little bit smaller. And again, you can't judge it based on, you know, the width and height of these guys, because he's going to end up falling, and it's kind of just a bigger thing for that sequence. Okay. So that's a little bit too big. Maybe a little bit too small. Okay, so just keep working through all of these different sprites. So see this one, how his head is really tilted? He might be a little bit tricky, but that's about the same size of the head, but you can see that the feet don't line up. So that's why we're doing that. Okay, and last but not least, the knight jump. You can see the movie clip name up here, by the way, if you need to know that. Okay, so he's roughly about the same size through all of these. Now, if we actually go and view this, Command, Return, or Control, Enter, you will be able to see each of the sequences. So there's a jump one, there's his idol, this is just a regular jump, and then this is where he's dying, running, walking, etc. So we can tweak a couple of these, like let's say we already did the, let's do the knight jump. So we'll unlock, see which one he is. Okay, so for this knight jump, you can see that he eventually goes from this lifted state. And I actually think that one would be a fast move, so I like that. So then let's look at this jump attack. And I think this one would be pretty quick too. So we'll just leave that one. and Night Idol. Now, this one I think is too fast. If we look at him again in the middle, he really looks like he's about to, I don't know what he's, it's like he's dancing. So I think he needs to slow down. So let's go ahead and go into the sprite, and we're going to slow him down by just taking each of these keyframes and moving it out. Now you can also go 3 frames out. You can do them all on one layer if you really want to. I've just found this to be more efficient to have each pose on their own layer. And then remember, we have to add time. So F5, or you can right click and insert frame, or go to the insert menu and choose insert frame. And don't forget the last one, and that should slow him down. So let's try it. Command return. Okay, so now he looks better with that idol. The other one I wanted to show you was the dead sequence, and he's a little bit harder. So we can actually unlock all of these and move them down. So we give our dead guy a little bit more room. Okay, so when he dies, he actually moves back on his own. So this is why you need to really keep that stacking order position the way it comes in originally. But notice that I had him moving slowly, a little bit slow. And then in the final dead pose, he shouldn't automatically loop back to this finished pose. So you're going to have to work or manipulate that. You're going to either have to create a stop action in this layer that it just stops at this point and he never gets up. Now the zombie, he might keep getting up. You never know. But make sure you add some time here so that he actually lasts if you don't put that stop action script in the movie clip itself. All right. So I think that sequence looks pretty good. So now that we have all of our movie clips ready to be animated, you don't have to use all these sprites. You could have done 2, 3, or 4. But it's nice to have all of them built so that you can get creative and not have to worry about rebuilding those sprites if you're missing a move. So we want to do this all on the main timeline. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the rulers and go to view and clear guides because those get on my nerves. All right. So I think I'm going to start out with him walking in. So I'm going to just, let me think about this. You can either delete these layers and just create them as you need them, but I think I might need them. So I'm going to just shut them off for now. And you could, if you wanted to, you could just have all of these extra ones hovering in the air so that you can really clearly see what's happening down here. I like that better. All right. So I'll lock all of those to make sure I'm only messing with the walk layer. So I'm going to have him walk in from off stage. So because he is a movie clip, we can now click on him and go to insert motion tween. And then it's going to make it last for a second. So let's say by this point in time, I want him to move this far onto the stage. Okay. So when that happens, you're going to need to hit F5 to make the background last. And let's go ahead and do command return so that we can see what's happening. So he's going to walk straight onto the stage and see how fast he goes. So just by doing that little sequence, I know I need to maybe stretch that out. So again, I'll hit F5 to make that last. Command return or control enter. Okay, so by lengthening that out, it's really going to help him look a lot better with his movement. So let's say at this point, I have maybe my zombie character come in, and that's, you know, building the sprite the same way. You might need to flip those pictures, and you can always do those by going to, modify, transform, flip, horizontal. So they might be facing this direction too, but if you want them to face this way, you're going to have to do that flip before you create the movie clip. So with each of these sequences, so I want him to walk, and by this point he gets here, and maybe the zombie comes in, and maybe I want him to start running. So this is where I'm going to come and bring the run layer down. They don't have to be right on top of each other, but I like them to be. So my keyframes are just a little bit All right. So I'm again clicking and then clicking and dragging. So at this point, I want him to appear. So I'm just going to add way more time to that background. So at this point, I want him to appear with the particular run sequence. And I need to know, though, where he stopped with his walk. And I need my run to appear just a little bit forward from that particular position. So what I'm going to do is, with that keyframe selected, we'll look at this in medium view now. With that keyframe selected, I'll come over here to Onion Skin. It's the very this first button in this section. And this kind of shows you all the different poses. So you can see the tiny little movements that were created. So on this particular keyframe, I want to grab this object. Well, you have to unlock it first. I want to grab this character and I want to have him also kind of line up right after, align the feet, get him in the same sort of distance. And then this is when the run will take over. So now I need to again go to Insert, Motion, Tween. And I'm going to, let's say, have him run for this long. So I'll hit F5. And so by this point, maybe I want him to hit here. And when he does, now he's going to go, it's shorter. See, this part is shorter because he needs to appear faster when he runs. So always check this. Command, Return, or Control, Enter. Okay, so he's going to walk in and you shouldn't see too much of a skip, but then all of a sudden he runs. And what's going to happen right after he runs? Well, maybe he's going to jump. So I'm going to bring the jump down because I like him to have him stacked. I'm going to click once and then click to drag all the way. And you can turn that onion skinning off whenever you're ready for it. But again, I need it to sort of start a little bit forward from the last position of the run layer. So I'm going to go ahead and unlock, grab him a little bit forward, try to balance the distance that you see behind. And then at this point, he is going to jump. So we need to again do Insert, Motion, Tween. And let's say we want him to jump up by this time. So I'll hit F5 to add more time. And by this point, maybe I want him to be up here. So he's going to jump, and then the next section I'm going to have him going down. So let's see what that looks like. So he should walk in at a good pace, and then all of a sudden he starts running, and then he jumps up, and then we need to have him jump down, and maybe he stops, and then he attacks the zombie, and then the zombie's kill sequence activates, so he looks like he's dead, etc. So what you need to do is you need to create a full sequence that uses at least 3 different sequences for that full major sequence. 3, 4, 5, it's up to you. As long as you have 3, 3 is probably going to give you good motion. So in this one, we have walk, run, jump. Then we might add an attack and then maybe walk or run again.